Today's enlightening entertainment will be presented in Finnish and English, with subtitles in Arabic, Aulaksis or Vietnamese, Chinese, English, Finnish, French, German, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish and Thai.
I'm a vegetarian. I believe that the rest of society should be too, because I have not heard any sensible explanations as to why this should not be the case. Marcus Fenari, PhD, Finnish research scientist, vegetarian. Excerpt from The Past, Present, and Future of Eating Meat in Finland.
Tervetuloa älykkäät katsojat tämän päivän ohjelmamme pariin. Samalla kun ilmastonmuutoksen vaikutukset jatkuvasti uhkaavat miljardien elämää planeetallamme, tiedemiehet kaikilta eri tieteenaloilta ovat myötävaikuttaneet suuresti kiireellisen viestin levittämiseen ilmaston lämpenemisen pysäyttämiseksi.
When it will happen, nobody knows, but eventually the human race will either demolish itself, we will not be living on this planet anymore, or then there's the possibility that we become vegetarians, we change our perspective of the nature and other animals, and we will survive.
The whole point of my thesis was that this is possible.
Lihan kulutuksen on tunnustettu olevan suurin syy ilmastonmuutokseen ja osasyynä muihin ympäristöllisiin ja terveydellisiin ongelmiin. Huolestuneet asiantuntijat ovat ryhtyneet hahmottelemaan institutionaalisia järjestöjä, joita tarvitaan yhteiskunnallisella tasolla ylläpitämään kestävää kotiplaneettaa. Tutkijoiden edelläkävijä tällä saralla on suomalainen tulevaisuuden tutkija tohtori Markus Vinnari Turun kauppakorkeakoulun tulevaisuuden tutkimuskeskuksesta, joka sijaitsee Turun yliopistossa Tampereella, Suomessa. Maaliskuussa 2010 tohtori Vinnari esitti väitöskirjansa Lihansyönnin menneisyys, nykyhetki ja tulevaisuus Suomessa. Tämä on ensimmäinen tohtoritason tutkimus, joka tarjoaa sosiaalista ja taloudellista analyysiä osoittaen kohti kasvissyöntiä ja veganismia ihmiskunnassa seuraavien 50 vuoden aikana.
I have been interested in vegetarianism for quite a long time. One of the reasons why I continued to go to education in the technical university in Tampere was that I was interested in the environmental impacts that meat eating has. And I went there in order to find out that how much pollution actually meat eating produces. And over there the evidence is quite strong. And if you look at the philosophical points, those are, the philosophers have been doing their work for quite a long time, and that's the strongest base. And then when you look at the arguments that why you should eat meat, those are actually quite weak. You can't make any sense out of those.
Akatemian ylistämä ja tiedotusvälineiden ja yleisön suurta mielenkiintoa herättänyt taloustieteilijän tohtori Markus Vinnari tutki lihan ja kasvissyönnin tulevaisuuden näkymiä länsimaisessa yhteiskunnassa. Osa hänen tutkimustaan esittää vaihtoehtoisen näkymän ympäristön kannalta, joka tekisi kasviperäisestä ruokavaliosta kannattavan vaihtoehdon.
There is global warming that is a mega trend that is going to affect us all, and in the longer term we are probably going to handle that somehow, or the other option isn't very likable. There is also water shortage. We need to change our agricultural system somehow. And one really big aspect of that is that what are the end users going to use? Are they going to use meat products that are going to need a lot of resources, or vegetarian products which don't need as much resources? So basically when these larger changes that are needed are understood, then we can start looking at the picture that are there some factors that are already happening. And when you look at it, you start to notice that, okay, there is actually quite a lot of happening.
Tiedemies tohtori Markus Vinnari selitti, että kolme käsitettä olivat väitöksessä muotoilemassa tutkimuksen kehitystä. Syvä ekologia, syvä vegetarismi ja ekologinen nykyaikaistaminen. Hän kirjoitti.
The deep ecological principle states that the human perspective towards nature and animals should change towards one which sees animals and nature as having value inherently and not being valuable only as material resources or by the well-being they provide to humans. Deep vegetarianism argues that humans have the moral duty to become vegetarians. According to ecological modernization theory advancements in human capabilities, that act as a driver for technological development can be seen as answers to environmental problems. Excerpt from The Past, Present, and Future of Eating Meat in Finland.
Some people are really interested on the environmental aspects of it. For example, the greenhouse gas emissions are something that is almost daily in the news these days. And people are becoming more and more aware of the fact that methane is a really dangerous greenhouse gas, and they are changing their behavior because of that. Some people are really keen on to the ethical issues, and in my opinion, that's the strongest argument that there is. And of course, there are the health arguments.
Tohtori Vinnari uskoo vahvasti, että yksinkertaista informaatiota kasviperäisen ruokavalion hyödyistä tulisi jakaa koko kansalle, jotta päästäisiin eroon liha- ja maitotalouden ylläpitämistä myyteistä. Lisääntyneen ymmärryksen myötä voi nopea muutos kohti kasvisruokavaliota ilmetä valistuneen väestön parissa.
In Finland, when you go to the doctor's office when you have a baby, they hand out papers that are printed by food industry. So I was shocked actually that this happens even in Finland, that there is material put out by the food industry over there. And of course it says that you need to drink milk. It doesn't say that you need vitamin D, it says that you need to drink milk. When I started to be a vegetarian more than 10 years ago, nobody actually knew what it meant, and they were quite sure that, okay, you are not going to have enough nutrition and you are not going to survive. Now that you go to the university, quite a few of the ladies are actually vegetarians, and this is something that has happened quite quickly, and nobody questions the fact that actually you couldn't survive.
Tämän lisäksi on lukuisten eläinten havaintotutkimusten ja eläinkommunikaattoreiden lausuntojen nojalla paljastunut laaja ja tutkimaton eläinten älykkyyden valtakunta. Tohtori Markus Vinnarin tutkimus tähdentää, että kaikella elämällä on oma arvonsa.
The well-being and flourishing of human and non-human life on Earth have value in themselves, synonyms, intrinsic value, inherent worth. These values are independent of the usefulness of the non-human world for human purposes. This principle states that not only anthropocentric interests are relevant. Hence, when making decisions, the end result of their effects on other animals and nature should be evaluated. This is because there is good evidence available of the environmental consequences of meat eating and strong arguments in favor of giving intrinsic values to production animals. Adhering to this principle would lead to vegetarianism. Excerpt from The Past, Present, and Future of Eating Meat in Finland.
For example, I've been quite a lot of involved with animal welfare researchers, and over there it's not even allowed to say that some animal is sad, because there is this idea that the animals are so different from us, even though Darwin said quite a few years ago that actually animals and humans are quite similar. There isn't that big of a difference. It happened just during the few years, and now that I speak to those researchers, they are saying that okay, the animals are actually experiencing the same things, and they are have the same feelings as we do. But now we are just in the beginning of being able to say that out loud. We are able to write that in a journal article.
Väitöskirjassaan lihansyönnin menneisyys, nykyhetki ja tulevaisuus Suomessa tohtori Vinnari sukeltaa kasvissyönnin historiallisiin perusteisiin ja painottaa ihmiskunnan välttämättömyyttä palata kasvipohjaiseen ruokavalioon.
How we, the world could become vegetarian in, during the next 50 years. And one of the ways that I saw that it could happen was that there is some crisis, a global crisis, that people get aware of that, okay, we did it, this is our fault, what should we do about it? And that's of course one possibility, that if there is such a global crisis, which is severe enough, then there is going to be large implications to all, to our consumption practices. We need to think about the technical aspects of it, we need to think about the social aspects of it, we need to think about the political aspects of it. All little advancements are needed in these different areas, and we don't know at what point it will just start to go automatically. There needs to be more research on the health effects of vegetarianism, how to build up a really healthy vegetarian food circle. That's something that is really important, because that information needs to get into the school system, that that is information that needs to get in to the nursery system and to the mothers of little children. That's something that is quite important, that people don't have any fears.
As there are possibilities that humankind and all other life will be faced with catastrophes in the form of climate change caused by environmental degradation, and as the number of animals slaughtered in the agricultural sector are staggering, action needs to be taken to avoid catastrophic consequences. The use of more efficient forms of food production, i.e. not meat, would help avoid such environmental degradation. Excerpt from The Past, Present, and Future of Eating Meat in Finland.
Lihasta vapaat päivät, jotka on omaksuttu ympäri maailmaa, toimivat parhaiten esimerkkinä toivorikkaasta alusta muuttuvan yhteiskunnan uudelle ajatusmallille kestävästä ruoan kulutuksesta.
I was enormously happy when the idea that once a week they offer vegetarian food in the school system went through. It's not only that the children get a taste of vegetarian food, but it also makes the cooks who are making the food think about what they are making, and they are starting little by little to think about how to get a real nutritional values into those foods. And even though it's just one day a week, it means that the whole food acquiring system needs to tackle that, and there needs to be better cooks. They need to know how to make vegetarian food. Then there needs to be a shop that sells them these products, and when they sell these products to these schools, these products will probably become more cheaper and cheaper. So basically then the children can go home and tell their parents that I ate this really good vegetarian food at school. And as those foods become cheaper, those parents are more probable to buy those products. So it's a really, really big change when you start to think it in that respect. And these are the type of things that needs to happen. In the same way, if you are a vegetarian, ask your friends to come over and teach them. Just say, taste this, and how does it taste? Tomorrow, ask your neighbor or your friend or somebody that you haven't offered a vegetarian
dinner before to come and eat with you and offer them something really nice that they would actually like.